By default, the Safari settings on your iPhone are designed to use unnecessary cellular data,
right,
slow down your iPhone, and allow trackers to collect information about you.
That's not good.
Let's change some things. First, we're going to have to open up the Settings app, scroll down, and tap on Safari. First thing here is Preload Top Hit. We're going to turn that off.
You're on Google. You search for something. Safari is automatically going to load the first result, assuming that you're going to go to that website? Nah. Turn that off.
You got to think too, if it's a web page that has a lot of video, a lot of text, a lot of photos, that's going to use a significant amount of cellular data. And if you're on a low cellular data plan,
yep,
you do a lot of web browsing, you could burn through your data pretty quickly.
And battery life, it's going to use extra battery.
Yep. So if you scroll down, next up, let's talk about closed tabs. By default, it's set to manually. And if you're a tab hoarder like me, things can get out of control really quickly. And if you have like hundreds of tabs open, it can slow down your iPhone. So what I like to do, switch that to after 1 month. If I don't go back to a web page after 1 month, it's a pretty safe bet I'm just never going to get there.
Right. I'm on ESPN.com, but I don't want ESPN to know that I'm also looking for vacation spots in Tahiti. How do I turn that off?
Well, let's go back to Settings Safari. Right here, Prevent Cross-Site Tracking, turn that switch on. Pretty simple. It's not on by default, which I think is weird. And if you go into Google Chrome settings, it's actually the opposite. It's like enable cross-site tracking, and I think Google might have done that intentionally.
Google has their own tracking built into the Chrome browser now, so they don't need to have this setting. So they're saying, oh, look how secure we are, but it's all just built into the browser.
One below Prevent Cross-Site Tracking is Hide IP Address. You've got a few options here. Trackers and websites, trackers only, or off.
Right. The most secure, obviously, is trackers and websites, but trackers is really the best option because some websites do need to know your IP address. A lot of times your general location is inferred from that. So for instance, if you're on a website and this is off, you're trying to place a bet on DraftKings, you can't do it. Come back here, trackers only.
Yeah, let's step back to Safari again and scroll down here to settings for websites. First, we're gonna talk about is camera. Do you want to allow camera access to all websites when you're using Safari by default?
I think not.
You do not. So you can either set it to deny, just no chance, or ask. Maybe there are some websites you want to have access to your camera from time to time. They have to ask before
sure.
They can do it.
There are websites where you have to upload a picture of your driver's license
sure.
for some sort of a personal confirmation thing. I like ask on this one.
Yep. Tap back to Safari. Same thing for microphone. Ask, deny, allow. Again, I'm probably going to choose ask on this one.
Right.
And same thing for location. Ask, deny, allow.
Ask, deny, allow. Who's deny, allow? Ask her.
Next, we'll talk about a new feature, iCloud Private Relay.
iCloud Private Relay is a very buggy, very problematic new feature that's supposed to make your iPhone more secure, but just ends up breaking like 20% of the websites, including Google half the time.
Yep.
So turn it off.
Now let's go back to the main page of the Settings app. Scroll all the way up and tap on your name at the top of the screen. Then tap on iCloud. iCloud Private Relay beta, tap on that. So it is in beta mode. That is one of the reasons why it's buggy right now. It's also just buggy in general.
And that's their excuse for it.
I've had a lot of issues. I've been surprised by how many issues I've had on my iPhone browsing the web because of this feature.
Right.
I just turn it off.
Run for the hills with this feature. But there is something you could do to increase your privacy online and speed up your web browsing, and that is to download the Cloudflare Warp app, or you could just set your DNS servers to Cloudflare. Why don't we just set the DNS servers real quick?
All right.
We're gonna do it manually because the app, some people have had battery issues.
Yeah, so back to the main page of the Settings app.
Right, we're gonna go to Wi-Fi, and then let's click the I next to the name of your Wi-Fi network, and then go down to DNS, configure DNS, and then change it to manual, and get rid of what's there. Add server, 1.1.1.1. And then add another server. Google is going to be our backup server. If the first one doesn't work for whatever reason, it always will. But if it didn't, you're going to want to have a backup server. 8.8.8.8.
8.8.8.8.
Right. So Cloudflare has this worldwide network of servers. They're very good at privacy. We'll drop a link to how much better it is, as opposed to DNS, which usually is hooked up through your cable modem provider. And they love to spy on you. So did you know that your Spectrum, for instance, by default, can see every website that I go to?
I did not.
Yeah. Well, they can't anymore because you just did that.
That just happened.
Let's tap save, upper right-hand corner of the screen. Those are some Safari settings you need to change immediately. Thanks for watching this video. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed. Please subscribe to this channel.
Because why the hell not?
Yeah. More tips like this.